who received a report from the select committee. But we will also reinforce that select committee and we will go and attend meetings of that select committee, especially when Musenero appears there.
What happens if, how would the public, an ordinary person, try to interpret this out now?
This is protection. You need to go back to 2003, during a meeting of the Movement National Executive Committee in Changwanz. Miriam Atembe was Minister for Ethics and Integrity. And in that meeting, I was a journalist working for Monitor. Matembe told Mr. Museveni that you are the one protecting thieves. She actually said we were fighting the chairman of Rakai district at that time over corruption related, but he went running to State House and you protected that guy. That's what Matembe told Museveni. Museveni cannot claim that he wants to fight corruption, but he also wants to protect people against investigations. Which hand? I don't accept which hand. But investigation, why should Museveni, the one who was quarreling over Anani and Sewanyan, that why are you protecting suspect? Now, this one is just under investigation, and Museveni is quarreling with investigation.
So, it also brings me back to the question of where does this put the fight against corruption?
Under Museveni, it's very difficult to fight corruption, except people who have fallen out with him. When Tumukunde was in jail, he was visited by Brigadier Stephen Kashaka. Both of them, Kashaka had been accused of helping himself with money made for salaries of UPDF. But he told Tumukunde, for me, I went and pleaded and I was forgiven. Why don't you go and ask the president to forgive you? So, Sare, what happened with Sare? With $600,000? The president said, no, you can use the, okay, I have now heard that you have been given a bribe, you can use that money. So Museveni cannot fight corruption because the moment you want to overstay in power, there are interests that you will have to protect, whether wrong or right. So and these are the interests that are going to make Museveni vulnerable in the fight against corruption, because there is no way parliament will say, want to follow this money. And you say, don't follow that money. You are disturbing good people. You are disturbing decorated officers. Decorated officers, are they doing private work that they must not be followed?
So, decorated officer. So, should we say Dr. Musenero is part of the so-called untouchables?
I asked in parliament here, if you were in parliament, we asked her questions.
There are other ministers who wanted to answer on her behalf. And I asked the speaker, Musa Sizi, because it was the first time to have a minister appointing himself a spokesperson of another minister who is present in parliament. That's why I asked that this minister, a super minister, that when you ask her questions, others must answer. I think they must have read that with Musenero, oh, that is a live wire. So if you want Museveni to like you, you need to be defending Musenero, whether she's in the wrong or right. So you can really see that. And these things is good, they are happening now. Because I asked, I have never seen this happen over the last 20 years, that you ask a minister a question, and other minister are jumping up to answer that question on her behalf. But with Musenero, they did. Well, I think she's very special.
Where do you see the fate of these investigations?
The committee, we voted in parliament to have a select committee. So that select committee will be checking it, even has a timeline within which to report, and will be asking, where is our report? If they can't do it, then we'll go and pass a motion in parliament.